Seeing none, although we're doing one each individual one, correct?
That was just the third.
Okay. All those in favor of the motion, say aye.
Roll call, please.
Roll call, what has been requested?
Roll call, bill two, Mr. Huber?
Yes.
Mrs. McLaughlin?
Yes.
Mrs. Fairfield? Sorry, Lucas?
Yes.
Sorry. Mrs. Hilton?
Yes.
Mrs. Huber?
Yes.
Mrs. Rossell, and Mr. Perry?
Yes.
Awesome.
Okay, thank you.
Right, the next item is item L3, which is the paraprofessional tentative agreement. We do have members from the bargaining team with us tonight, and I also want to thank you for the sessions that we had and the respect that went back and forth both ways, so thank you for that. This tentative agreement is within the parameters set forth by the Board of Education. The tentative agreement with Lance Cruz, AFSCME Council 25, AFL-CIO Local Union 1993, was ratified by the union membership once again on August 31st, and is recommended for approval by the Board of Education.
Is there such a motion?
So moved.
Okay, I have my trustee McLaughlin, and second by Secretary Ross. Are there any questions on the motion?
It's a statement, again, I appreciate, and again, these are times nobody relishes, but the fact that people are willing to come together, sit down, and try to work in the best interest of both our employees and the district, it's greatly appreciated by the board.
Second.
Okay, any other questions, comments? All right, seeing none, all those in favor of the motion?
Roll call.
Roll call vote, what has been requested?
Roll call on L3, Mrs. McLaughlin?
Yes.
Mrs. Ross?
Yes.
Mrs. Huber?
Yes.
Mrs. Fairfield?
Yes.
Mrs. Hilton?
Yes.
Mr. Huber?
Yes.
Mr. Perry?
Yes.
Awesome.
Carried unanimously, again. Nice job. Unfinished business. There's nothing there, unfinished business?
I just have one thing, and this is, previously I requested Mrs. Johnson the evaluations that she completed for the people who are under me. I did go ahead and go through all of those. However, what I noticed is that while you have the assistant superintendent evaluations, you also have one director evaluation. Are you not responsible for all the director position evaluations, or if not, who is?
Yeah, I provided to the board in the EduPortal for the request of the Board of Education, where I learned the evaluations of the people who directly report to me, management people who directly report to me, and those people that I evaluated. Other directors report to other people. For example, our director of special ed reports to the assistant superintendent of secondary education. I'm not sure who else has the director title, but they report to different people.
So I guess probably what I would like to see then, specifically, is where you all are directors report, because if only one director reports to you, I guess I don't understand why we have a director reporting directly to you when everyone else directs, is reporting to someone else.
So
if you could give us that breakdown?
You already have it. And one of the requests that came from another board member was the number of employees by group, you know, by union, or job function, by building. And so, 2 or 3 weeks ago, we posted on EduPortal an organizational chart that has every employee in the district, not listed by name, but so every facility, every building, every employee that's in that building. So you can look on those organizational charts and see, pick a building, and you can see how many management people are in there, how many clerical people, how many custodians, how many transportation, and it's all there for you.
When was that updated?
I sent out an email to everyone letting them know that.
The reason I'm asking is because I have the org charts that have been provided previously. Obviously, I haven't looked at that one, but the org charts that we have from previous instances have not even been a little bit accurate.
I would welcome you being specific about what it is, and I'd be happy to address it, and so then I stand by that they are accurate. So bring me some specificity, and I'd be happy to address that.
I guess I'll have to look at it. Thank you.
That's right.
Well, I can have one director report to you. Well, she did her evaluation.
I thought that was answered already. Okay. So, who else, Amy?
We know that Mrs. Johnson is going to be giving her letter of resignation on October 2nd, which is a Sunday. I would be concerned that we should have it on September 30th, which is a Friday, last business day of the month, because October 3rd is the Monday and that's our next meeting. If we do not have a letter by the 30th, I think we should have prepared a letter of separation so to keep it official.
Okay. I guess my understanding of this is that there's nothing that I saw in her contract that extends her, like, gives her an automatic say. Right? She has 90 days in her contract to put her request to separate in. If we have a board meeting on Monday and we don't get something that Monday, what I see is that we would act on that Monday appropriately. I don't see anything in her contract that, you know, requires her to do anything past 90 days. So it'd be a question for her. I personally don't see in her contract that way. So if we have a board meeting that Monday, we act appropriately.
So I do have a little bit to add.
Okay.
I had tremendous concern about how we would go about that, and I just want to kind of go on the record here. We have had more than our share of trouble with Leslie Robinson. Jackie has spent countless hours on the phone with them, you know, spending time with them and things like that. I don't think it would be appropriate law firm for us to utilize
I don't know if we would need to use an attorney. In my personal opinion, it would be something very simple as to a vote taken at the table. I mean, if we can get something. But I've talked to the superintendent, I've talked to Jackie, I know she's sitting right here.
Okay.
But she had told me that she will be giving her letter of resignation. And if we don't get it, we would have to take appropriate action. So if we get it on that Sunday or Monday, granted it's not the 90th day, but it would still be appropriate for us to act. I don't think we need to get an attorney involved, in my opinion.
So I just want to be sure that when we discuss the lawyers,
it's $1 million.
When we discuss the contracts with the lawyers, I was under the impression that we did put out a RFP and start looking for lawyers. And then I was informed that vote had something like a sealed contract for the next year. And that's not what I was going to leave when I asked questions at the meeting. So I just want to be sure that there's nothing that's going to change and we're held liable for something we weren't planning on.
I know we're going to get this letter from the superintendent, and if we don't on that board meeting, then we will have to take appropriate action.
So I'm going to go ahead and go out on the limb here.
Okay.
There's been a significant amount of gossip, and the gossip is saying that it has been relayed that the plan is to turn over the board. There are 3 seats available this year, and hopefully with the board turnover, Mrs. Johnson remains the superintendent. that has been said by people who have actually been recruited by this administration. So my concern is that we have our ducks in a row, especially with the interim superintendent, the firm hired for a new superintendent, and just plain and simple, the moving forward of the district. And I hate to say it, but it looks like that's a probability that she refuses to give us a letter.
Well, I don't think she's refusing to give us a letter. She has told me several times that she will be giving a letter. And I'll be honest with you, I really don't like acting on rumors or what people are thinking. I strongly believe that if we move forward, if we don't get it on Monday, that this board has the authority to take action that day. And we'll have to see. But I strongly believe that we will get that letter, Mary. I do.
I understand
your concern. I do.
Well,
I understand.
She hasn't given it to us by now. It's a bad professional move not to do it. It's
in her contract
right
that way. And that's what it is.
I'm just not in the level that we're kind of waiting.
I understand, but sometimes that's good to wait.
No, I'm just saying, we keep pushing this issue because there's some concern on some board members' parts that she's going to do some kind of flicky thing and stay on as a superintendent. I would suggest the gossip is ridiculous. I was doing it, I was spreading it, but it's not true, it should stop.
Well, right, there's a procedure here in place, and I think I like staying with the procedure, and I think it'll work on that time, and also I'm not eating my words, so. But I think this board will have the ability to act that day, and we will get a letter from the superintendent for her contract. Okay, anything else under new business? Unfinished business, sorry. We're under new business now. Anything under new business? Okay, correspondence?
No.
Nothing. Board member requests? Yes.
I have a quick question.
Yes.
Correspondence, are we not including emails in our correspondence? I thought we talked about that.
We have talked about emails. There are emails directed to the secretary as
someone who is submitted to the board, then that happens. If it's just someone sends an email to all of us, I don't know if there's anything about bringing those in and let's talk about when we have addressed this before. So whatever comes in addressed to the secretary gets brought to the board and the public at the board meeting. Is there a particular email you're referencing?
No, not at all. Okay. I just know that I'm doing most of my correspondence through email. You know, while I do write cards and letters, I have spoken frequently that I hate to have us be missing information because we are only looking at.
If they're addressed to the secretary, if it's an email or something in my box or something mailed to me here, mailed to my home, which is where I'm here, I'm right at the board table to the public.
So should we be including things that are sent to the entire board of education?
No.
Okay.
Okay, I don't know the policy on that. I have to do some research. Okay. So we're going to
look at what we could include and what we should.
I'll do some research.
Thanks.
Okay, board member requests, audit requests, and our packets. There is just to give a little background, some of the board members have met with the auditors and have requested that there be a deeper dive into some of the expenses for the audit. And so now came up with additional costs that would be involved if they were to do a deeper dive, and it's in our packets. So I asked that they put together separately the total cost if we were to do one or all, and that is what we have in front of us today. So I'll entertain either a motion or discussion in regards to the information in front of us.
Question.
Okay, go ahead.
My understanding is that they have finished their audit already, the regular audit. And so these specifics that were brought forth are 1, 2, 3 are on one issue, one's on a second issue, and one's on another issue. So there's three different issues and 5 different things here. Is there any amount of time that they have discussed yet that they think will take them to release these particular things? I guess what I'm trying to say is, in relation to the audit, they've already done X amount of time, X amount of dollars. How will these three issues compare? Do they have any rough idea of what amount of time they're going to spend on this?
I don't, and I'll be honest with you too, that I tried to get the auditor to come to the meeting today, so maybe, because I knew some of this would come up.
I was going to ask for Shelby, I think it's going to be answered.
The auditors are out in the field, but they are back at their office. They are trying to schedule, we're waiting to hear from them for a meeting to go over the file, find out what's outstanding, although we've been in contact with them, we've been giving them everything. My understanding from Jennifer Watkins is that once this is approved, that she will come out 2 days sometime at the end of September to do this work.
September, do we know the amount of time this is going to take?
She said 2 days, which she was expecting to be.
And then my second question is, to that would be, since you just finished with the audit with them, do you feel or shall in your capacity in the business office that 2 weeks for the questions being asked and the dollar amounts being spent is sufficient, okay, not enough time, just enough time, sort of like, you know, just right, not just right?
Are you asking her if you think it's, if she thinks it's appropriate or if she thinks it's a good idea?
I'm asking her the question I asked you were appropriate, never came out of my mouth. I want to know, since audit was finished, do you feel that 2 days to do these things before you with a dollar amount attached to it is the right amount of time? Too much time, a little bit of time? I was asking our business office professional her opinion on this, because this is above and beyond audit, which we're all aware of, and I just want to know, is this going to be sufficient? Will this settle the questions once and for all? Will we say, oh, well, they didn't spend enough time on it, we didn't spend enough money on it? What in the world is this going to do the job we're looking for? And I realize, first of all, I'm kind of putting you on the spot by saying, but in your professional opinion, do you think that 2 days is sufficient for what's being required here?
I would say that 2 to 3 days for the items listed in the form that you're looking for approval. I know there were other items, and I am making the conclusion that they were done during the audit, but I don't know if that's a fact.
Okay. Oh, go ahead.
Rochelle, do you think the 2 days that you spent is going to be collecting the data and then go back to the office and review the data is more like collection days?
I don't believe so. I think what they'll do is they'll ask us for the information, we'll prepare the information, and they'll come in and audit it.
Okay.
I don't know if you would know this, Michelle, but as part of our regular audit, was any of this looked at in those annual samples that they pulled?
In the random samples, I could not tell you if they did that. You know, they would be preparing a financial statement for the international fund, so I don't know if they did any auditing on that, so they should have a good handle on that. You know, the JJC is a separate program. They would have to go in and look at that program expenses. And as far as the non-affiliated employees, I'm not sure. I'm sure they did some type of testing of employees. I just don't know who and what level that they did it on.
Just a comment. I'm very disappointed that a representative from the Home Bill is not here this evening to answer these questions.
And I'll have to take responsibility for that, because I did not ask them to be here for that. I thought of it this morning when I called her. So I did not ask her to be here, so that is my fault.
Just my perspective, my two cents for what it's worth. We have had the same auditing firm for the last 26 years. And what I have learned, including WWE, as a standard practice, is that you change your firms up every 3 to 6 years. You change up your firm to get fresh eyes, fresh perspective. We haven't done that at all. I think that we need to do the due diligence of doing an actual audit. I mean, anything that was a concern to somebody needs to be looked at.
Okay.
where there's smoke, there's fire sometimes, and we really hope that that's not the case. So I think this kind of alleviated a lot of concerns.
Okay.
I hope it does, as I said, I hope it puts things through.
Is there a motion so far?
I don't have a motion.
And then,
go ahead, Don.
So my understanding, what we see before us, $10,200 for 2 days' work, is that correct?
For how many people?
Do we know how many people?
There isn't sure.
How many staff members came out on the audit typically on a daily basis, you know, approximately?
It varied. I know they had, the majority of the time it was due, Jennifer was in and out as you would expect a partner to be. That's our criticism of her. And then I know there were some people that were here for like 3 days straight and spent the night in one of the hotels, so they were here consistently, so.
Typically
I would say
two.
An average of 2 to 3, and they were here to the middle of the week, so they didn't take the full 2 weeks, I don't believe.
So they're not here for us to ask how many people are assigned to this. We don't know if one person is making $10,000 for 2 days or for 5 days.
Were there questions that you had before the meeting that
you could have sent in? Yeah, they probably said no.
No, that information.
Okay, time out.
So, a little bit of perspective, we pay our attorney $450 an hour, 8 hours of work for our attorney, so when they work is $3,600.
So we're overpaying.
You know.
The bottom line is we had several trustees, several board members that asked for a deeper dive into some of the funds that we have, and this is what the result is. If we want to proceed with the cost of doing the review and the deeper dive, then that's what's in front of us today. So
I make a motion that we proceed with the items listed here.
I'll second.
Okay, I got a motion by Trustee Hilton, a second by Vice President Sir.
Roll call, please.
Are there any questions on the motion?
Just a quick comment.
Yes.
Was this before? I don't have a problem with this. I think there's, you know, sometimes you just need to do that deeper dive, or if you haven't changed authors in enough time, that's fine. But I really would like to see that this kind of this 3 to 4 year thing wasn't at all.
Excellent.
Okay, roll call. Mary?
Yes.
Amy?
Yes.
Pam?
I'm sorry. Oh, yes.
I switched over from full names to half names. I thought that'd be consistent. Sorry. Don?
No.
Linda?
Yes.
Mrs. Ross?
Yes.
Mr. Fay?
Yes.
Someone.
Good stuff. Okay. Thank you. Moving on. Superintendent search firm. For those of you that are maybe new or haven't heard, our superintendent is leaving at the end of this year, in December, and we have made a motion to put a RFP out to find a search firm to help us find an interim and a permanent superintendent. Last week we had two meetings that consisted of 6 firms coming in and making presentations over 2 nights. It was very good. We had a good discussion the second meeting about the firms. I was impressed by the product that was brought forward to us. So what we put on the agenda today was to hopefully possibly come up with a firm that would be able to help us with this search. We've built a matrix that involved costs. We've done also questions and asked questions of these firms. So at this time, I would ask, I know that we talked about likes and dislikes, but if we have, if this board has a firm that they are truly considering versus people that we're not going to consider, I would ask that we start there. So is there any firm that stands out to any board member in particular, or a motion that might be made in regards to hiring a firm?
Yes.
Okay.
I'd like to move that our board go forward hiring Hazard Manning to do the superintendent search firm.
Support.
Okay. Motion by Treasurer Hornberger, second by Trustee McClatchy. Is there discussion? Yes.
There was a communication. I want to understand that the amount that we're considering has been adjusted to reflect their competitive pricing with the interim search.
Correct. And just for the edification of the public, we Don had asked the question at the second meeting about because their cost for interim was more than the other firms. We reached out to the firm and they lowered the price. So, correct. Correct.
Just for clarification, I apologize. Within their original proposal, they indicated that they would meet the pricing of any other firm. I'm not suggesting that our intent was to renegotiate the proposal. It's basically to act on something within their current proposal.
Correct.
Which included a competitive pricing clause.
Correct. I believe, yes, that's what the correspondence represented. Exactly.
So we their interim search is now inclusive.
Correct. They said that would be included in the total cost. Correct.
So
yes.
I did reach out to, was it Pearson Jacobson? I think that was the other one that we all pretty much agreed on. But however, I did not get a call back from them at all. My question to them was going to be, because I think most of our concerns with that group was the interim and how they would write that, how they would go about that.
Okay, so any other comments on the motion or questions? All right, seeing none, all those in favor of hiring Hatton Young for the interim and superintendent search?
Yes? When will they start? When will we be sending contact?
I believe they said it started right away, but I would have to look at the RFP. When we built in, well, they were going to help us with the timeline. The next steps, my guess is that we would have to draft a contract with them and make sure that everything's in there that we need and get going. So, yes? Okay, is there any other questions? All right, seeing that all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed? Very unanimously. Nice job. That was good. Felt good. That felt good. Felt good, right? Okay. Excellent. Legislative update. I don't have anything for a legislative update. Anybody else? Okay. Calendar events update. I do have something under an event update or calendar event update. I don't know if we have our calendar update event person here, Kelly. So if you'd like to update us on this event.
Thank you very much. We just want to make everyone aware that we'll be having our 30th annual movie night. It is scheduled for September 17th. We will be showing Utopia. And much like years past, when we start at 7:30, 7 o'clock gates will open. But we are alternating which building will be at each year. So this year it will be over at High School North on the football field. I've gotten smart, and just in case it rains, we do have the following Saturday resort as well as the 24th. But it's September 17th, absolutely free. The athletic boosters won the concessions. So there is a free local there, and it's a wonderful time. So come out, bring your lawn chairs, your blankets, glow sticks, Wi-Fi.
I would like to add, though, unless you said it already, that this movie is being brought to you by sponsored by the Lance Crew Foundation, which is, I'm finding out, is a beautiful organization that does great things for our district. So thank you. Okay. All right. Next, we have a motion to go into closed session pursuant of 8C of the Open Meeting Act to have a strategy session connected with the collective bargaining or labor contract. This requires a roll call vote.
Make motion that we go into open session pursuant to 8C. Pursuant to 8C of the Open Meetings Act for the purpose of a strategy session connected with collective bargaining or labor contract.
Motion by Trustee McClatchy, here a second. Second by Vice President Servio. A roll call vote is required.
Mrs. McClatchy?
Yes.
Mrs. Servio?
Yes.
Mr. Goodwin?
Yes.
Mrs. Hollenberg?
Yes.
Mrs. Hilton?
Yes.
Mrs. Ross, yes. And Mr. Kelly?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, time is 7:36, and we are going into closed session.
I did provide everybody a stack of documents and emails that were requested previously. I did arrange them by date and took out all the duplicates, just so that you know, and I think that's applicable to our closed session tonight.
Okay. Okay, it is now 8:21. We are back in open session. The last thing on our agenda is a motion to adjourn.
So.
Okay, by Trustee Hubler and Trustee Hilton, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed? Carry unanimously. Have a good night, everyone. Thank you for coming.